All right, are we going?
Yeah, good.
All right, everyone, here to show you how to set up your spirometer, and we're going to actually use a lab quest, but we're going to have the lab quest graph projected onto computer screens today. First thing we want to do is we're going to show you how to set up the spirometer. Okay, if you notice here, we have one side that says inlet. Okay, you're going to take your bacteria filter, the large end of that, large side of that, I guess, will fit on to the spirometer itself. And then you're going to take your little tube here, little cardboard tube, and these are going to be individual use. Okay, so if you have a couple people using it, you need to get a new bacteria filter, and you need to get a new tube. And you're just going to put that tube right over top there. Okay, so that's what you're actually going to be breathing into, right, when we set it up. Right, so you can set that just aside for a second. Next thing you want to do, take your USB cord. Got a standard USB and then a mini USB down here. Standard USB, you're going to actually plug it into the USB on your computer at your bench. I'm going to plug it in down here since we're working with a base station. Set up, okay, and plugged in. And then once you're plugged in there, you can take the mini USB and plug that in there. Okay, and it may kick on. If not, if your LabQuest does not kick on, just go ahead and push the on button. Okay, next thing you want to do is take your spirometer here. Okay, got our plug. And we are going to plug it into, it doesn't matter which one you do, but there you go, plug it into that, get a good click, and we're all set up. Okay, so as far as structure, tools, we're all set up there. Let's take a look at what we need to do for our computer. So the computer program we're going to be working with is called Logger Pro, right here, and they're going to be in different spots on each computer, so just have a look around. Go on there, double click. And then what will open up is this graph. And we actually want to change this. I'm gonna make this a little easier to read today. So once you get, this will probably come up, the flow rate measurements here. What you wanna do is go up to File and hit Open. And you'll get this drop-down menu here. Go to Human Physiology with Bernier and double click on that. And then scroll down to number 19, lung volumes. You can double click on that or single click, then hit open. And it should change you to this new one. So this one says flow rate measurements. Right? What we want to do is go up to this little menu, drop down, and choose lung volume. Right? So notice what we have here. We've got two graphs. We're going to click on this graph, and then we can just delete that one. On this, we've got a lung volume and capacity. So we have our time here. We have our volume over here. We need to change this time a little bigger. It's just 60 seconds, 0 to 60. So we're going to go up to experiment, extend collection. So that'll go to 90 seconds. And then we're going to do this again. 135. Okay, so now we've got a time frame of 135 seconds. Volume is the same. We are all set as far as the computer goes, and this will collect all our data. You can see as you scroll across here with your mouse, okay, it gives you a reading of time and volume, okay. And so when we get our graph, when we've done our experiment here, you can actually roll over and just kind of hit your peaks and valleys. We'll show you what that means in just a second. All right, so we're going to go ahead and run this experiment. And again, we've got our spirometer here. This is the end we're going to breathe into. First thing we're going to do is go ahead and plug our nose. Okay. That allows us to make sure that all of our breath just goes through the spirometer, comes out our mouth, okay? And if you go back to the computer here and looked up here, okay, you're gonna have an active collect button. So that collect button, When you're ready to go, you are going to, your partner, you are going to go ahead and click on this. One thing about this, using this, is you don't want to be waving around. You want to keep this pretty steady and at a constant level with your mouth. All right. So let's go ahead. We're going to go ahead and start this. And when you go ahead and breathe into this, you don't want to just breathe in like this. You want to put your mouth all the way around it. All right, so here we go. I'm going to take four regular breaths, and then I'm going to hold my breath for 20 seconds. If you can do it for 40, great. I'm old, I can't. And then we're going to take four regular breaths after that. All right, here we go. All right, and once you get that fourth breath, your partner can hit the stop button. You can remove your nose clamp, okay? Set your spirometer just down on the table, that's fine. And you can take a look at what we've got here. So you should have a nice graph that looks pretty similar to this with some waves here, we've got some peaks and valleys, and then a long pause, and then again, peaks and valleys here, okay? If you look on your data sheet, okay, you're going to have a couple of columns and rows that you need to fill out and fill in some of the boxes there. There are going to be before questions, so before you hold your breath, and then after you hold your breath questions. You're going to want to get your volumes. So what you can do is you can just put the mouse on your peak here if you want. And if you look down here, we've got a volume of 3.01. So you'll record that. And then if you go down here, you've got a valley of negative 0.49. And so you'll record that. And then what you'll do is you'll take the difference between them. And that's going to give you your total volume here. Then if you move over on your data sheet, you will be asked to find the time of the second peak. So if we go over to your second peak, put the mouse there, we've got 7.7. That corresponds with 7.7 seconds. And then go to your first peak, and this corresponds with 2 seconds. So we're going to have, we'll take the difference between these two peaks, and that gives us the length of time for one breath. And then you'll record that at the last, second to last column. And ultimately, the difference between these two, you'll divide into 60, and that will give you your number of breaths per minute. Then for after, you're going to go over here and do the same for your after holding your breath.